I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. What I'm hoping to help you out with right now is to let you know if you should be seeking out and picking up this. This is New York City Classic Edition. This is not the deluxe. This is the retail version of New York City, which is number 3 in the Stefan Feld City collection from Queen Games. This is actually an update, and I wouldn't say reprint. It's definitely an update, a remashing, a remix of Rialto for anyone who played that. That's a classic Tasty Minstrel Games game that has been long out of print. So this is a new version of Rialto, totally rethemed to represent New York City, which is an area control game where you're going to be building skyscrapers around a map of New York. Now, I don't want to go too much into detail about the game. I just want to show off what you get. Now, like all City Collection games, this is a big, heavy box. I'm expecting a lot of cardboard and quite a bit of wood. Now, there is a deluxe version of this and a deluxe upgrade kit. That is not what we're looking at here. We're just looking at the Classic Edition. So here you have the box for New York City, the City Collection number 3, Stefan Feld City Collection. Queen Games, again, one of the things Queen Games has been doing, which is awesome, is producing more green games. They do a lot of work to use recycled material and sustainable material. Oh, that was a good box fart. All right, we have bag of wood. That's what we start with. Massive bag of wood. And one other baggie? Two. And two other baggies. Sorry, interesting. I am going to guess these baggies are for these cards. All right, what do we start with? Cards? No, let's save the cards for last. So we're going to start by tossing the box lid where I can toss this stuff. We'll get back to cards later. Oh, there must be an ad. Ad here. Okay. Let's do the inside first, and then I can get this box out of the way. So, German glossary. In English, it is the addendum. This is something we're seeing in all of the City games and something I do appreciate, which is definition of terms and then reference to cards and icons. And that is exactly what you will see here. Now, compared to the other games in the City collection so far, this is the lightest of the first set of 4 games. Then we have the various characters and then characters with this icon. So little summary of what goes onto the different boxes, onto the different cards. Then we have the German instructions and then the English instructions. Not a thick book, very blue. Everything's very blue. I'm going to move these out of the way so they're not taking up all the blue. So you can kind of see it, and you're seeing the difference between the deluxe and the classic version. Again, we do have the classic version. We're going to get to see all this stuff, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time on here. We got the board set up. This will be a much simpler board than many other Queen games we've unboxed and reviewed. Goes through the various characters, lots of examples. Queen is also known for color coding their rules. So you'll notice, like, important terms and characters, playing is in purple. And then the general rules for each round. And then you have the cards and their actions are in blue. I love the fact Queen does this. And then phase 3, which is a different phase, is purple. And then end game is green. And the solo rules are here, where you're going to play versus Tom, the automatic character. Interesting. That works. Solo rules are almost as long as the base game. And then we have the advertisements of the first 4 games in the series. We will be doing reviews for all of these games eventually. We're getting there. Just taking some time. Cardboard. It's a Queen Games game. Cardboard and board. It's going to be thick. Yep, it's thick. We're now going to move the main box out of the way. We're going to go through punch boards. Oh, folded punch boards. Okay, so we have all the various people you can hire who all go on an elevator. And these are the player boards, your fat stacks of cash, some tokens for showing what areas are on the map. We'll flip these. You've got the closed elevators, and you've got the backs of the other stuff. Here's the elevator board. You can kind of see here. It's looks like puzzle fit. Let's try. Yeah, you got puzzle fit. I'm not going to build it, but it would go here. And you have your elevator, which is a sideboard. these tokens go between the various areas of New York. In the deluxe version, these are wooden. There should be, yeah, they're over here. There's stands to hold these up. These are various scoring opportunity tokens that will get put onto the different parts of the map. And a whole ton more people, because these people are a huge part of this game. What citizens you hire is a big part of the game. Then we have the other player boards for the other two players, more fat stacks of cash, and then more people, including the starting characters, which are on the open elevators. So you can see that here. And that's it. There's all your cardboard tokens tossed into the lid. The board. Wow. Okay, they do not make small boards for the city series. This is probably going to be one of the least busy boards I've ever held up, yet it still is huge. Look at the size of this thing. Like, you're going to put skyscrapers onto this map, but it's huge. I'm wondering if they went with a... So you probably can't hear me behind this. I wonder if they went with a standard size board for the entire city series. And that's why this is quite as big as it is. So you've got a score track around the outside. You've got the newspaper track, which determines ties and things like that, telling you how many cards you've got. Then you've got the connections. So one of those, I don't have in front of me, like a cab would go on this yellow route and a cab would go here. And whatever that is, a ferry, a gondola, what do you call it? I don't know. Would go across here. Wouldn't be a ferry in New York. Possibly it would be, actually. So that's there. So what we should have left is... Is there anything interesting on the bottom? I don't think there is. Yeah, just the rest of the score track. There's a spot for a special token here, and then these kind of rotate in that can be earned every round. But man, massive board. Massive board. Cards. Big part of the game is cards. This is a bidding game. You are going to bid on actions. The person who bids the most. Interestingly, like, everyone gets to take the action. So it's got the... you know, Race for the Galaxy follow kind of thing going on. And you're going to get as much as you bid, but whoever bid the most gets a bonus. Okay. There probably is a quick thing on here, but I'm just not wasting my time on it. Of course, I'm failing at using the hobby knife today, so. Okay. We're going to have advertising. No, not even. Okay. Sorry, but. I am sure it has to do with the amount, but it's like, I guess you could use this as a checklist, whatever. Reference cards. Yep, reference cards. Then we get the game cards. Oh, it's just like deck one, deck two, I guess. So yeah, blueprint cards. Then you've got, whatever. I can't remember the names of the various phases, prestige card tiles. Building instead of blueprints and so on. Wild cards. The big part of this game is drafting these cards to make your hand and then making a bid. These are the backs, except for this. So that's just more reference cards for the four players. And then you have your other action. Here's the newspaper action. And then you have the money action. And the hire people action. Whatever it's called, the elevator. And then there's more blueprints. So this would be one massive deck. Obviously, first time you play this one, you're going to want to shuffle that up really good. So it's one of these, you know, if I bid two, and if I bid three, you bid two, whoever bid three, I'm going to go up the newspaper track three, but I'm going to get a bonus one because I won the set collection thing. That's kind of your main mechanic. And then it's area majority for who owns the most skyscrapers in each area. So we're going to put these just to the top a bit and dig into the wood and plastic that we have in here. Bag of bags. I play yellow, so I'll hold one of these up. To be fair, they're nothing fancy. They're big, kind of chunky. It's a skyscraper. It is a yellow wooden skyscraper. I am not going to pull them out for the other colors because it's a blue skyscrapers. It's green skyscrapers. It's red skyscrapers. Now, I will admit, Queen Games still has stuck to the standard player colors. Blue, yellow, green, and red, which can be a problem for some people with color blindness issues, especially blue-green. These are plastic stands that would hold those transportation vehicles. These are the style that they're using in all of the city series. It's kind of funky. It's not quite the same, and it's designed not to damage the cardboard. You also get a set of black buildings. These are neutral buildings to mess with the count, and there's systems for putting those out. Then you've got some trackers in the player colors. Really simple. Again, I'm going to hold up yellow. That's to track your newspaper. And it's kind of like a newspaper shape. It's a wooden block that's mostly rectangular. And then you have a yellow disc that is for tracking your score. Black disc is another one. It's a neutral color. So it's a neutral thing on the newspaper track. There you have everything you get with New York, the City Collection. Now, if you do pick up the deluxe edition or the deluxe components, these are all silk screened. So the newspaper looks like a newspaper, not just the shape of a newspaper. More, what's cooler to me is every player's skyscrapers are not only silkscreen, but they're unique shapes. They look different. That, I think, is really cool. I don't know if that justifies the cost of the deluxe edition for some people, because that's really all you get in the deluxe edition is those two changes. You do get wooden versions of the transportation vehicles as well, instead of the standees. All right, I am going to use those other bags, put these away, but at this point, we're pretty much done. All right, next thing I'm going to point out, Queen Games is not a box insert company. Though right now, this is only for you who are live, they have a Kickstarter running right now where you can get the new something edition of this game with an insert. They're redoing the whole City Collection right now with inserts. The special edition, I think, because there's Classic, there's Deluxe, there's Kickstarter. Then there's now whatever special edition that has inserts. This is a game that could use an insert. I got to say, looking at that, that is a bit of a mess. Especially, and I know Deanna hates it, cards in baggies. All right, there you have what you get. New York City. City Collection number 3 from Queen Games, a re-update, a re-release, a revision, a remix of Rialto. Significant rule changes, though, so this is rating way better than the other game is. The people I've talked to who have played both prefer this version. I am really looking forward to digging into it. As for surprises or anything unboxing this, there's a lot of cardboard in here. Rulebook was a little thicker than I expected. Lots of chunky wooden buildings, just chunky, nice wooden buildings. Cardboard standees, quite a bit of punch boards. Oddly, two bags to manage it all, though I have a feeling once we open up all the wooden pieces, that'll free up some other baggies. A box insert may be something you want to invest in if you do check this game out. My biggest surprise, though, is just how massive the board is. The board for this game is huge. It's going to take up a lot of table space that honestly, I think it doesn't necessarily need to, but that does seem to be a thing with this. Like they're going for this certain deluxe appearance of big games on the table that take up lots of room. So this does follow that trend. So there you go. My initial thoughts on City Collection number 3, New York City from Queen Games, a Stefan Feld game remix of Rialto. I am Mo Tuzano, Tabletop Bellhop. Find me at tabletopbellhop.com, where eventually I will review this game and let you know just how good it is compared to Rialto.